Welcome to the Empire Bite, this is Rampaned, and welcome back to a new campaign that I'm starting today, Bulat Steel. I've had this recommended to me for a long time, and I'm finally starting one. We're going to be playing as the Kingdom of Sweden, as that was what we ended up winning in my faction polls, and we're doing an early campaign conditions, starting in 1100. This is going to be interesting, because the victory conditions for us is going to be basically controlling a lot of shit around Scandinavia, and a bit of Russia, and I think, because let's see, I have to eliminate for sure Kingdom of Denmark and Novgorod Principality. I kind of, for myself, the initial idea I'm thinking is like, okay, hey, let's kind of stay around the coast, kind of, I would love if I could technically go back to Pagan Ways. I don't think I can, technically, sadly. But what I'm wanting to do is maybe, since I don't have to kill Norway, maybe see if Norway wants to ally with me. And we could try and make a Scandinavian alliance to kind of control Scandinavia and kind of control the coast, kind of go attack Britain and a bit more of Russia. I think that could be kind of a good way to kind of go about this campaign, is kind of focus on that. Not go too far inland, seeing as how, I don't know if that works for us. I kind of want to focus on like some pagan Viking ideas, where we're going to focus primarily on coastal kind of engagements. I kind of like that idea. So let's see. I need to read through this, as I've never played Bulat Steel yet. So let's see. So F3 and keyboard to open up the guides again. Introductory in message. AI can't difficulty with very hard, so they get a bit of different additional income and morale. They put stakes down in battle after it started. Oh god, I'm gonna be careful about that. Okay, so let's see. Some factions have similar genealogical trees, and only the ruling branch is shown. All the children are kind of age. Okay, birth rate in the game is proportional to controlled cities. That's pretty normal. Hidden resources is center of trade route. This, I'm not sure what they specifically meant by this. Also, the merchants will be able to trade them while in the city. Okay. Ruler coronation script. This is something I definitely know I'm going to have to take into consideration. So, as a henceforth, if after the death of the incumbent ruler, the heir does not appear in the capital for coronation within a year and a half of the trait of the first level. So, it sounds like he gets kind of a negative trait if he doesn't go to the capital to be coronated. That's going to be interesting to deal with, because I always use my heirs and my faction leaders a lot on the battlefield. Let's see, now you can make money donations to generals to increase their fidelity. Okay, so I can kind of bribe generals to make them a little bit happier. That'll be kind of nice. And then let's see, time spent on general companies. Okay, that seems pretty simple. System of ranks. AI strength is cool, hardcore fans. Garrison scripts. This is something I'm going to have to take into consideration, because I know every single city is just going to have some sort of garrison, a very large garrison. So I'm actually have to utilize some different tactics that I'm used to specifically make sure I can take cities very quickly and ignoring the garrisons. Because there are a few things I can technically try and do for that. So, prices for resources. So resources, depending on three factors. Level of the trade and capital, remoteness of the... it's pretty simple, pretty normal. And then, okay, so public order in the cities has been seriously changed, increased fines for everything, the difference in religion, high taxes, communication, excommunication. So this is kind of the reason why I want to kind of really stay close to my own stuff, and I think we'll kind of stay very close to Scandinavia, because it's going to be very difficult for us to be able to actually maintain the stuff that we've got around here. And then the Golden Horde script. So there's no actual diplomacy with them, and they actually have like their own unique script to kind of make sure that they're just a huge force on the field. That's going to be interesting. And it looks like they've expanded on the schools and library stuff. And there is a supply system. Okay, so I will have to be careful of that. So let's see. So troops under the leadership of the general need supplies. Supplies, blah, blah, blah. Restore as soon as your enemy rests in some settlement or after taking an enemy city with 50% of your religion. Okay, so I'm going to make sure I actually properly kind of explore areas around me before I... Oh, and I just need to send my spies out. Not spies. My priests out. But no, I know for myself, I love the fact so far. Just, I haven't even really done anything, but I love how much I can customize the Bulat Steel campaign. And I really like this closed map effect, because I know this is like what they had in the Americas campaign. So I have to actually explore and like look about and see what the hell is going on. So what I'm going to do is, let's kind of, first and foremost, for me playtesting a little bit and kind of testing around a little bit with this, it seems like one of the best ways for me to get some early money is definitely these chapels, because that's going to be another 100 gold there. Also, it lets me help get some conversion around here. So right now, financially, we're not doing so hot. I'm losing about 2,400 per turn, and I need to blitz some areas to make sure that I got some money. So what we're going to do is, I know I need to take this city, but I need to be careful about a garrison. So what we're going to do is you're going to start sieging this. Don't actually build anything right now. Just kind of wait. I'm going to have you do that first. Just sit there. And what I'm going to do is here, give me a Bone Spearman, and then I'm going to have you guys all come around this way. Because what I'm going to do, and what I know I can do, is I can have it so that what I do is you guys shouldn't be attacked right here. You shouldn't be. And then what I can have happen is you'll kind of come over this way, kind of siege from this side, take out most of these besides my general here, so you guys can go join up with this army. Then, if you're sitting there and these guys don't actually siege it, they will sally out, and I can kill these guys. Because these guys aren't that great. Spear Militia, and then I can't see the status of these Viking Raiders or the Levy Archers, but I know these guys aren't the best. And my Cav is pretty fucking disgusting. So I should be able to easily destroy them. Oh, look at these, yes. Even some of my infantry, like these guys are pretty good, the Foot Huskarls. Those guys will be pretty good to face off against the enemy. And then, because I just need to lure you guys out. Oh, actually, you actually have some of these units, so I can see what their stats are. Okay, so those aren't too bad. My spearmen are a little worse than them, but if this is going to work exactly how I want it to, I should be able to take this city, not this turn, but the next turn afterwards. They should sally out and try and fight me. What I'm going to do for now is, let's take you, and let's go kind of explore a little bit, and try and find some resources I want to look for. I'm going to bring these ships down around here in a second. I want to kind of scout along the coast here, and see what settlements are around here. Because I know there's got to be some land up here. Okay, so there's another one. Bothna. You guys also have Skinny and Swordsman. Oof. So they got some stuff there. Yes, that kind of looks like the edge of that area. Because I know there's a city right here that I need for my victory condition. So I'll try and go for Visby at some point. But for the most part, right now, I need to try and take you. As you're the closest settlement to me besides maybe this one. And there'll probably be a pretty good area to start going for with it being a castle. It should be easy to defend. My spy... Let's have you kind of go further down this way. And then I'm gonna... Oh, there's Denmark over there. I want to try and talk to them and try and get some map information. So you guys kind of make your way over there. And then next turn we can properly set you guys up to try and take this city. Oops, I accidentally messed this up. So I'm actually gonna have this withdrawal just for a moment. It did lure them out, but basically I need to get everybody else set up first. Eric Jensen, oh man, your loyalty is really bad. Technically, this will... I will be able to bribe you. I'm going to accept you for now. Having an extra general right now is going to be very useful, but no. Now I can do it exactly what I want, because I want you there. And then you need to go from this angle. Oh, actually, you need to not be sieging. So you need to stand there. You guys group up with him. Next turn, I'll get the proper assault that I really want, because then I'll actually have all the reinforcements. I could have possibly won that. Oh, they did get a new unit. Shit. Okay, I think we should be okay, though, because now I've got this guy, because they should sally out. This guy, they'll go after him. These guys will be on the other side, and they'll just kind of ignore him. That should work out perfectly for us. But you guys here, what I'm going to do, because right now, I need a priest. I do need to make sure I'm properly going around and trying to convert all of these guys. You guys here, let's see, I could actually jack up the taxes quite a bit. That would help a little. Because we are losing, yeah, about 2,400 per turn right now with what we've got right here. Because right now, a lot of these things don't give a lot of boosts to my economy. Like, this would if I was actually trading right now, but I have, like, barely any trade. I probably... Ooh, bread market. Let me get a merchant. Wouldn't be a bad idea maybe to get that? That's pretty cheap. It's 1,200. Otherwise, we could try and get the roads just to make it so it's a bit easier for us to walk around our own lands. Cleared field. That's a pretty basic amount of food. So, like, I can get about 80 more here. That's not bad. It takes two turns for that. But one more turn for the bread market. Like, it give tiny increase in that, but it would let me get merchants. Which, do merchants have... They don't have an upkeep, do they? It doesn't let me tech. Pretty sure they don't. Because we grab that. I just need to make the most out of my money before I'm just fucking dirt poor. Like, oh, this well wouldn't be bad, maybe. It would help me get some... Make sure my generals are healthy. Maybe do that. Let's grab the bread market first. Because if I can get some merchants, and I can actually get some pretty good trade resources. Like, let's see. This makes me about 36, 13, 20 for that amber. Keep exploring around here. Kalmar. Okay, so there's another castle I'm probably going to want to go for. If anything at all, at least the cities being set up like this is going to make it so that I should probably be able to pretty easily expand faster than the AI, because I think I'll be better equipped to try and deal with the AI like this, the garrisons, than the AI will be.
Ready to trade.
What else is around here? Anything else? We gotta explore Scandinavia and figure out where's the best trade resources for us. Otherwise, I'll probably have to bring you somewhere else to actually make a decent amount of money. So let's see. We're still losing money slowly, and I know we're going to go into the negative at some point. I know we are. We finished that chapel, and then we got some bonds for him just to kind of help out. Oh, there's a new video for the wedding! Interesting. I don't know where they got this from, but hey, it's kind of nice to not have the same thing over and over again. It's got to be from some random-ass show or something. I have no idea. That guy looks awkward as fuck. But we'll end this turn. I'm sad I don't have any missions right now to try and take land. Because I really do need some more money. Like, we're going to be, like you have a lot of people have said, it's not a Rampaned campaign if you're not dirt fucking poor and bankrupt. So let's see. I'm going to have you kind of explore a little bit more around here just to kind of double check and see if there's any city. Okay, there is another city right here. Sala. And then I think that is about it for over here. Yeah, that's it for there. Okay, so then let's kind of go back around down this way. So we have a couple settlements to try and conquer initially. So we've got this, this, a lot of castles. Because I'm thinking we'll probably want to go for Visby next after this city. Because I need more money. I don't think this one castle is going to make me enough money to sustain me right now. So we'll probably need to take another city at some point soon. Because I'm literally just going to have to conquer as much as I can with these small little forces that I've got. There we go. That's the one I want. Because now, this force, they're going to try and attack him. They shouldn't have any more units than what they had before, so they have a little bit more than last time. This guy, okay, so he's got similar stats to you guys. A little bit higher defense. Attack is the same, but defense is a bit higher. But what I should be able to easily do, well, I'm going to command you guys myself. This guy is going to run the fuck away and try and get closer to my main forces. I'll have it so that we'll set up and have them break themselves against my infantry. And we should be able to very easily crush these guys and take this castle. Need to make sure I minimize my casualties, as I really, really need to make sure that we make the most out of our units. So you, I need you to run over this way. Let's get over there. I kind of like this music. Also, I need to look at this. These guys look pretty badass. I like that. Like, this unit model is a beautiful one. Walls seem to be updated a little bit. Some of the units are rushing out. Okay, okay. But yeah, now, so I need you to make your way over here to group up with my guys, because I've got 3 units of cav. You guys are going to want to run over here. You guys are going to want to run over there. And then I've got you, you, and you are kind of my basic infantry. And I'm going to have to make sure I take be careful with my Huskuttles. You guys are a good unit, so I need to make sure I take advantage of that. So I'm not going to have you guys be a frontline unit. I'm going to try and actually have you guys flank more often, as I don't think I really need to try and throw your force away as much. So I'll have these guys, since they're more basic, kind of try and hold the line. So now my guys are set up. You guys are going to try and, again, hold this front line. You do have shield walls initially, but I think I'm going to have you guys stay as you are. What I'm going to do is cav. Let's take you guys. Their skirmishers right now are kind of on this flank. They only got these 2. They're decently exposed, and so I think I should be able to get some decent charges in on them before they get into me. I know Desert Ranger, one of the guys that watches me, he's going to love how every single unit I have has shield wall. Every single one of them. You know what? Fuck it. Let's put you guys in shield wall. You guys have some time to adjust. Cav, kind of try and run over here. Are they going to try and shoot me yet? No, they're still getting into position. So Cav, kind of be right over here. Kind of wait right on this side. Infantry, I'm going to have you guys kind of adjust a little bit. So kind of adjust there. Archers. Oh, you guys have really short range. They should be opening fire now. Release! I do like the music they've got for this. I like the music they've gotten this mod so far. So you guys, maybe get a couple shots off. Not doing a ton. Save you guys pull back. That was a kind of a pretty small volley. You guys kind of run away around this way. Ignore these guys. Their skirmishers are standing right there, so we should be able to easily get to them. They're kind of separated away. They've got like 4 units trying to chase me here. Oh, you guys are supposed to be getting out of there. Come on, get out of melee. You are not supposed to be fighting there. Hold, men, hold! Oh, that's way more damage than I would have liked. Okay, you guys get over here for these lovely archers. Off to a great start, losing so many dudes because of some just bullshit. Stop shooting me. Here comes my cav. Fucking wrecking them. Oh, that was a good charge. Absolutely destroyed those guys. Okay. Those guys are all breaking already. Nice. Let's see, that unit's still trying to fight. You're trying to. Let's kind of try and run these guys down first. Ignore those units. Kind of try and run over here. Get away from these units. I need them to actually get into melee before we engage them. Like, you guys charging here should be able to easily break this guy. Yeah! Oh, I fucking shredded them. I'm melting them like butter! I love it. I love it, I love it, I love it. Yep, get in melee with me, you guys. Archers, I'm gonna have you guys. I think you're fine as you are. Let's kind of let them keep getting into position before I charge in again. Get out of there, guys. I know you're very eager, my king, to kick some ass. But we need to be careful about this. Let's have you guys kind of run back around this way and get on this side here. Let's bring in the Skulls. Let's have you guys kind of run over here and try and help out. You guys kind of try to run this way. Yeah, those archers are storming away. Lost half their army so far. Okay, now you guys get in here. Cav, I'm trying to get you to about right here. Archers, you should be shooting these guys that are just sitting about here. Almost there for my cavalry. Oh, this is a sergeant spearman here. Oh, they're pushing in. If we remain well, let's make them regret their decisions. Victory will be ours. Blast the horns. Oh, you guys could go into wedge if I wanted you to. Here we come. Oh, they're breaking before I even get to them. How's that sergeant spearman doing? Oh, they're broken too. Okay. Cav, run them all down. These guys are still trying to fight. I'll let you guys just be shot at for the most part. Because right now, they've now lost 70% of their forces. We can just kind of let them advance into me. And then just wait for them. Because right now, my cav can just be a nuisance. Just run around. Make sure they're still close enough to be shot at. You guys move up a little bit. You guys kind of readjust. Kind of right there. You guys can kind of pull back again. And then cav, let's just kind of bring you guys back around behind us. As we're just trying to wait for them to get back towards my archers again. So come back here. Because we've only lost 6% of our forces. Hopefully we'll recover a decent amount. And then if I can just get these guys to fight my melee units again, we'll easily be able to destroy them. Because, oh my god, I love the cav in this mod so far. Bashing them against a shield wall, it's fucking beautiful right now. Because come on, archers, keep doing a little bit more damage. Let them just engage us, and then we can finish them off. Are you just gonna sit there? You have no archers now. This is such a poor excuse for Nords! You're just being shot at by my dudes. Like, straight up, just sitting there being shot at. Let's kind of at least run around and make sure we run these guys down as they are wavering. Because we've almost got them all. There's not that many of them left. There we go. So we've now captured him. Run these guys down. And I think at this point, like, they've got a couple of guys standing right here. They've got some guys inside as well. But I think my cavalry should be able to easily just finish you guys off. Run you all down with their captain dead. I should be able to easily just run you guys all down. Break them on my charges practically instantly. Oh, wow. Okay. I was like 60 feet away from you guys and you still decided to just break instantly. So I'll just run these guys down, then we'll just go back to my allies. And as soon as we wait out the battle, or we can just keep running them all down, we'll win this battle and get this castle. God, I've got some disgusting cavalry. Like, how'd they do? So actually, my levy archers got the most kills, actually. You guys actually didn't get that many kills. Okay, so my cav got 39. It was actually my archers that did the most. My Foothuskarls got 31. No, actually my archers. Wow. I did not think you guys got that many kills. Because I know you guys captured a lot, but huh. I thought my cav did more on their charges. But I guess I was wrong. But that's one settlement for us, at least. We have now conquered a little bit more of Scandinavia. As I'm probably going to either... Okay, either I'm going to go for Visby or Kalmar. I might go for Visby first. Let's sack this settlement to get a little bit of money. I might go for Visby first, as it is a city, and probably will make me more diplomatic relations. Give me some military units. Ooh, yes. Alrighty then. I'm already making my way over this way anyways. As you wish. There's Lund. Try and just explore this area. So let's try to talk to this Danish Jarl. Let's see, you guys. Not the bad. The treasure's scant. I'm pretty poor. Military power is zero for me. Let's just try and offer some trade. Mutually beneficial offer.
It seems we have reached.
And then can I get some map information, maybe? Yes, it is beneficial for both of us.
We accept these proposals.
I'm not going to offer you guys an alliance, as I know I need to kill you at some point. So I'm just going to try and get that map information from you so I can at least have an idea of what's going on around here. So then I think from you, let's kind of keep going up this way and try and go talk to Norway next. And then you... Oh, I forgot. I do have princesses, which I'm going to try and send you. Because I want to see, if I can get an alliance with the Norwegians, I kind of want to take it, because I don't have to kill them. Good. One of the reasons I would love to be able to kind of switch back to paganism is just kind of for more of the RP aspect of it, but also, crusades. We actually will have access to crusades still, which is going to be nice for us. So we'll try and see if we can go talk to Venice, not Venice, Norway, see if we can maybe get an alliance with them. Maybe we will, maybe we won't. Ooh, characters receive new anchor. Huh. Okay, that's a lot of stuff for you. Jarl of Uppsala. An architect. I think I'm gonna have you stay around here, and you'll just kind of keep watching over this place for me, man. Let's see, this area is at 82%, this is at 76%. As again, we want to make sure we're taking into account... Oh, also another reason why I want to go for Visby. That's silver. Ooh. Okay, so I was given some units, so let me take you guys. I had a new general. Oh, my crown prince is here. Okay, so let's send you guys over this way. I'm going to send my crown prince over here as well, because I'm going to probably be using him. I'll probably leave you here, but what we'll do is I'll take my king. Let's see.
Yes.
I do have enough movement to get you guys just barely over here, so we'll drop them off onto the ship, and what we'll do is I'll take my heir. I'm going to hope you'll be fine without any guys around here. Because I just don't have any free upkeep units right now. Actually, I probably could have you guys be free upkeep. Yeah, these guys might be free upkeep here, actually. Because they cost 195 for their upkeep right now. This army alone, I think, will still be fine to push forward. And I'll have you guys try and go for Visby next. That should give me a decent amount of money. You guys here, again, I think I need to get the chapels. Again, that's one turn, and it gives me another plus 100. So that's very useful to get my economy up on track. And then Uppsala. I think for you guys, maybe we should get... Because I grabbed... Oh, actually, first. Agent limit... Oh, I'm already at the reach of that. Okay, because right now, what I could do, if I just want something cheap that'll have benefits long-term, is going to be this. That'll help me grow my settlement a little faster. That's 5% tax bonus. That doesn't really do anything right now. This does give me about another 80 per turn. Or I could get the roads. The roads won't give me all that much money. It'll go up 5. My trade is going up, so maybe it will be beneficial. But also just increased movement around here I think is going to be very beneficial. So maybe we should grab that. I think that's what we'll do. Because I'm going to start going negative, and I just need to keep rushing as quickly as I possibly can. Yes. You guys can't go any further, but I should be able to set up the battle next turn. And the turn after that, we should be able to take Visby, I believe. Because I'm going to hope that maybe try and find... Oh, that's another level somewhere right there. Because let's see, I know this is some wood that's 15 per turn.
Yes, there's money in this, my lord.
I wonder, because did I find anything of value? Ooh! Allows a train of camo-mounted units. Wait, what? I think that's just glitched. Okay, I don't think that's actually what it is. Ooh. Great, what's this? This is just says trade resource. Doesn't specify which one, but that's 157. Yeah, because as we get a little bit further away, some of these are making a little bit more money. I think I'm going to bring you over here. That makes 157 per turn right now. That would be very nice for us. Another general. I don't think I'm going to take you, though. I don't like your... I really don't like your loyalty being so low, so I'm going to reject that. Especially since I want... yes, capturable settlement for Visby. Good, I want that. I want that money. Bankruptcy. Okay, so let's see. So you're struggling with your economy and do not know how to plan... Let's see. with your economy and do not know how to plan the cost of running the treasury. Now your treasury is less than zero and you do not have enough money to keep the army, so you just pay payment. Any way to cover your deficit, still offer your troops. Okay, this is just basic stuff. Because right now we're still losing about 1900 per turn. It's not as bad. I think. Are you guys not going to be free upkeep? Oh, come on. It says you're supposed to be free upkeep. And it's Sergeant Spearmen. These are Sergeant Spearmen. They should be free upkeep in that castle. Ah, damn it. Okay. But, you know, yes. I'm going to reject those guys as well, just because I'm still trying to send you over here to try and talk to Norway. I would like to see if we can maybe get an alliance with them, maybe? I'm going to hope so. So let's see. How are things going? Okay, so he's just being added into the house, it seems like. Jarl of... Yeah, I'm gonna really like making sure I focus on specific people actually being governors more often, I feel like. Because usually I focus a lot on just straight-up conquest. And I don't really pay attention to anything else. Let's see, so you guys go right here. So what we want to do is... Right here, take my crown prince. You sit there. Mercy is still just a ship. You sit right there. Then I will take the king. And you're going to sit right here. Again, same thing should happen. And I should be able to freely just kill all you guys. Ooh, that's a nasty unit. That's a nasty unit. But I'm hoping that once we take Visby, I'm going to hope I start making money then at that point. Because, like, we're not doing too bad. I'm going to be negative for a little bit, but we'll probably have to take Visby. Maybe even go up here still, and maybe then I'll start making money. I don't know. It depends on how much trade I start getting at some point. Because you guys don't have a port here. It's going to be a little while until I can actually get a port around here, too. Because, let's see, you guys, trading ports, I need to be at least a large town. Oh my god, there's a lot of stuff in here. Holy shit. There are a lot of guilds. Oh. There's a lot of things to... Oh, I love when there's so many things to build. Hey, from Skyrim. Large hut for hunters. Oh, I love it. I love it. I think with you guys, though, Noobsil, I am going to increase your taxes a little bit. That is a huge effect. 50%. So I can at least put it to high taxes. That helps a little bit. So now we're making a little bit more. But should at least get one more battle right here with Visby. And with that money that we're going to get, we'll be back in the positive again. Because they're going to attack this turn. But it's just whether or not I'm going to keep making money once I have it under my control. That's the question. And I don't know if that's going to be the case. Because Visby, I'm assuming, should make about... Maybe it'll make it so I'm just barely breaking even. Maybe. Because what we'll probably do is, after I take Visby, we'll probably go up north for that one city that I found. Take that one next. Because I need to be very aggressive early on in this campaign. Because right now, I don't like being in debt in my campaigns. I know it happens far too often in my campaigns. But I don't actually like being in debt. So we're going to try and be very aggressive early on. Try and do whatever we can to take as much land as possible. So that we're not going to be just in the hole. And so far, I'm really glad that this is working wonderfully. I can have one general kind of distract the enemy. And then I just need to fight you guys myself. And say a similar thing should be able to happen, where you guys will try and run to me. I'm going to wreck you with my cavalry, because, oh my god, I love my cavalry so far. It feels amazing with these charges. They do so much damage. The enemy just has, even with the bonuses they're getting on very hard right now, oh man, they're getting their asses kicked. Oh, it's wintry. It is very wintry. So let's see, let's go over here again. Need to group up with my allies. I'm gonna probably actually go up like right here. This is probably gonna be a better hill to kind of set up on, but let's get all my guys over here and then start with our defense. Ah, isn't this perfect weather for our Scandinavian veins to be fighting today? Because let's see, where are their forces? I can't fucking see. Viking raiders, where are their archers? There's Scandinavian axemen that I have to be careful of. More Viking raiders. More of their spear militia. I think they're archers. Oh, they're over here. Oh, they're isolated away. I like that. So let's kind of run off to the side here a little bit. And we can go get rid of their archers quickly. You guys should be unloading on the enemy. I don't know how the hell you guys can see, but... Start unloading on them. I'll have you guys fire a little bit before I have you guys pull back. Number one is already taking out a percentage of their army. Because their archers, I think, are pretty isolated. Yeah, here's one of them. Here's another one. Are things lighting up? Yep, things are lighting up a little bit. So let's kind of just charge over here immediately. These guys, I'm gonna have you guys kind of pull back a little bit. They just seem to be a little close. But Cav, let's kind of deal with their archers. Most of their infantry is away, that they're not gonna be able to really help them. You guys charge that one, and you charge this one. Come on, break their archers. Get rid of that ranged advantage they've got. Oh, that was a sharp turn. Okay, you guys get out of there. Go, go, go. Kind of running around this way. See if I can get a good charge on you, because for the most part, yeah, those guys are broken. Break them, please. Oh my god.
Let's pray to remain as such.
Half the unit in that charge. Holy shit. Okay, Cap, let's get you guys back over around to my infantry, as I see they are on combat now. They are probably getting their asses kicked by some of these Scandinavian axemen. Yes, they are. Okay, Huskarls, I need you guys over on this side here to help out. My Cav will be able to easily run into this dude right here. Lost 5% of my forces already. I don't like that. You guys run there. You guys can't shoot them. I might move you guys out to the side. Maybe. Because I'll have you guys try and get over here. These Scandinavian axemen are not nice to us. Get in position. There we go. Break him! There we go.
Has no honor.
Fighting to the death. Is he running already? Ooh, Scandinavian axemen are even breaking. Perfect. Okay, let's run all these guys down.
The battle is in our favor. If we remain true and wholehearted,
38% of their forces are already dead. Cav, let's have you guys kind of run on these guys down.
Glorious heaven above.
I do love that I get to really embrace my heritage in this campaign. I'm only a little bit Swedish. Like, well, let's see, my grandma is 50%, my mom... I should be at least bare minimum 12% just from my mom's side of the family. I know I have more Scandinavian from my dad's side too, or in just general, but I'm most certainly a Nord. And also, I do live in Discount Canada, so of course, I'm going to have some Scandinavian blood in me. Let's get you back up here. Because number-wise, they've lost about half their army. Cav kind of pull away from those guys. Let's just keep focusing on the units that they have back over around my infantry. So, kind of ignore these guys, but kind of run through this way. Need to get back over to this other side. Right here. Because I am starting to lose a little bit of my infantry. I don't like how much damage I'm taking on some of my infantry units.
Our men have
at least my Cav kick
the enemy
ass!
Bloodied.
I love
they
my Cav.
Lost half their men.
It's like you guys
the
are fighting to the death.
Our favor.
You already a silver chevron. I love that.
Victory will be
okay, let's have you guys kind of reform here. Cav kind of pull back a little bit. Let's let our archers just kind of keep opening up on them. Are they going to break? Are they just going to sit there? Oh, I think they're just going to sit there. That's boring! That's fucking boring, my man. Fuck it, charge them. I know it's a charge in the front, but I think they're going to break. They tried to brace, it just didn't fucking do anything when you're fighting against a bunch of angry Nords. I'm gonna run them down just for more experience for my Cav. I don't need to do it. It's because we've won the battle now, and the rest of their forces will die, but I'd like to get more experience for my Cav, because you guys are already silver chevrons. This is beautiful already. Because there we go. Okay, now my Cav did a little bit more damage this time. Let's see, we did heal a couple guys. I'm just a little worried on how much damage we're taking on some of my infantry units. Like, it'll slowly help me get back into the positive with money, but I also need to make sure I still have... Because the only reason this is working so well right now is because I have some good infantry that can hold the line while I try and break them with my cavalry. So now I've got Visby. Enemy camp is looted. Good news. I've moved soldiers to plunder the enemy camp. This is a reward to elevate the suffering of our soldiers in battles. The enemy camp turned out to be small, but we were able to get about 500 gold coins. Oh, you are so bad. No. Again, also, I'm trying to see if I can bring this over to Norway. Keep kind of exploring up here. Because I'll try and see if we can get Norway to like us, and maybe we can work with them. Maybe that's something we'll be able to do. Because I would love to kind of try and make an alliance with Norway. If they don't ally with us, then that sucks. Oh, I'm barely losing money still. Fuck. At least one of these guys is free upkeep. Okay, that's nice. I'm going to merge my guys together. Then I'm going to have you... Oh, let's see. It's still five turns. Okay, so I do have to go up here to to take that. So we're barely losing money. Hey, those aren't free upkeep. I hate that. For some reason, they should be. I don't know why they aren't. Let's bring you over here. Let's see if you guys, if you leave Visby and leave this one unit, will that be enough? Because I need to keep moving with this force. Yes, it is. Okay, so. You guys, let's see. Because we're losing only 400 per turn. You guys up here, is there anything else I can do to get more money? Because, like, I could get the farm. Number of free upkeep units. Ooh. I want that. But I need more money right now. Love you, archers. I think... Because how much trade do we make right now? Not much. It's still 17. I could get the better roads here. Try and get the better roads there. You guys, maybe... Maybe I should just get the cleared field. Just get basic farms. They're cheap. Basic farms are cheap. I'm barely losing money, and that will make it so you guys get another about... Yeah, another about 80. You guys also about 70. Corruption's going up by 1, so we will need to get some sort of law building here. But let's grab you guys, get you on the ship, and then let's see. So... I think I should just go for this city. We'll just go up here, go for you guys... I need this mine, but I need to be a larger city for a straight-up mine. Siege guns. Stone quarry mines. Yeah, for this area in Visby, oh yes. I could get up to 750 from there. That'd be pretty nice. Okay. We'll have to try and get that at some point. We're barely losing money right now, so if I can just take a little bit more land, I think we'll be okay. These are still rebels, so I'm hoping you guys are... having trouble trying to take these regions, because the AI also have to deal with those garrison forces. So I wonder, let's kind of look at this, I'm curious. Because I want to check, because I'm actually kind of concerned that I'm wondering, let's see, I want to look at maybe my neighbors. I'm concerned that the AI might not grow quickly enough to be a threat. Because so far, well, I am losing a lot of money, but right now, I've been able to take two settlements pretty quickly, and I don't know if anybody else... Let's see, let's just look at all. No, there are some factions that are still growing. Okay, good. I wasn't sure, because I know it gives them practically a full stack of dudes in the garrison, so I wasn't sure if that was going to stop and slow the AI's progress for expansion.
Yes?
I was kind of concerned that maybe it would be, because I know at least so far it looks like... Like, you guys, I'll have to see if you guys are going to succeed here. You got a full stack. So you guys might be better off than I would be, because right now I don't have a full stack. I barely have half a stack. Because you guys have... I literally just have these 9 guys having to continuously push forward into the enemy lands to grow a little bit, as I have no infrastructure to sustain me. And so we'll kind of hope that soon we'll be making money, because I'm pretty close. I'm very close. I'm only losing like 400 per turn right now, so I've got at least 5 turns of time to until I go negative again. And then I can try and take this one city up here, and then maybe after that one I can go for the other city that I found on the on Finland. Kind of start getting a little base of operations over there. I do need to get a spy into Russia and kind of northern Germany, so I can kind of see like what's going on with those lands, what are we going to do with them. Because right now... We're gonna try and see, hey, is Norway going to ally with me? I do intend to probably just go to war with Denmark pretty early on, maybe. Might be a good idea to just take them out. Well, actually, I'm a Christian faction, technically. So I can't be a complete dick. So they want trade rights, and they want me to pay 950 per turn for 5 turns. I'm not making any money, man. Fuck no.
Of course. It is your decision.
I'm not...
This
no.
Concludes our meeting, yes?
They took Oslo. Okay. Did they take any damage from that? It doesn't look like they did. Oh, that's bullshit. Do they just get to, like, take cities like they do occasionally? I don't want you again. Your loyalty is pretty low. Diplomatic relations with the Holy Roman Empire? I can do that. So let's take my diplomat down this way. Oh, wrong way. And are you actually trading? You are trading it. Oh, nice. Okay. So let's have you keep exploring around here. I will need to get a glorified watchtower builder at some point. But you keep exploring around here in case we ever do go to war with Novgorod. No, they took some damage. Okay. So they didn't get away scot-free from that. And then you guys are still building up. Okay, so yes. Now we can set you guys up here. Let's see, do you have enough movement to get the fight set up? Yes, so you go around right here. And then you... is that going to be... I think that'll be in the right spot. I think you'll still be okay. I think you'll still be able to get the fight started. Because I think he technically has to just not be in the immediate square right next to him. So if I was one further ahead, it wouldn't work. But I think right there will be fine. I think. Because I'm just kind of curious. So everybody... Okay, so people that I know are around me. I'm just kind of curious like them. So let's kind of look at that. So Denmark, I'm curious about... Scotland, I'm curious about. Okay, they're the same basically right now, but eventually I'll be wanting to worry about them. Holy Roman Empire for sure I need to worry about. Poland. Poland's actually lost land. Oh, Jesus, okay. Let's see, who else? Novgorod Principality, because I have to actually kill you. You're growing. Let's see, who else? You're also around here. You've kind of stayed stagnant. Kiev has grown a little bit. They're farther, too far away. Norway has grown a little bit. And then that's about it. Everybody else I don't care about. But territorially, most of them have grown a little bit. Poland's the only one that hasn't. Financially, I'm kind of near Norway, it seems like. Me and Norway are kind of struggling, but everybody else is kind of doing pretty well for themselves. But overall, I'm barely... Like, Norway's stronger than me. I don't like that. But yeah, so I'm growing slowly. We're now up to 3 settlements out of my 50 I eventually need to get. Because I'm curious, who am I going to have be my glorified watchtower builder at some point? I'll have to be like somebody that's not going to be an actual governor, too. Because there's so many benefits from, it seems like, with letting people just straight up focus on a city so often. God, I love, we've now practically conquered all of Sweden by the end of this camp video so far already. I love that. So, let's get this in here. This is a much smaller force. You guys have far less infantry than the other cities. Still the same cav units. Again, control these guys myself. They'll follow my crown prince. He's the bait. I can only imagine how he feels me using him as bait. It's like, yeah, lure them out of the city, and then we'll come in and strike them all and just defeat them all as one. It's a glorious job. He gets to do something. I'm just hoping he doesn't hate that he might die and kind of screw himself over. So it's kind of, again... You guys over here, let's see. I've actually got a good hill already, so I might kind of move you guys maybe just around here a little bit more. But for the most part, this is a pretty good hill already. Why are you guys so bad at defending your archers? Like, seriously, they keep leaving them in such vulnerable positions. Like here, I'm just going to be able to charge this guy, who is their captain. No, their captain's right there. So all their archers are dead now. Practically. Like, you guys are gonna break. Do kind of make sure you run over this way. They're trying to trap me, it seems, but now archers are running away. Kind of keep chasing them down a little bit, and then we'll come back as soon as they've kind of engaged into my infantry. You guys want to try and let you have some shots off, but then kind of pull back now. Get at least a volley off before you guys pull away. These guys are practically all dead. I can just leave them as they are. Let's kind of run back over... this way. This way to get that unit. That's actually there. No, that's not the captain. Their captain is a little bit further down. He's in this blob of guys right here. So let's get over here to the Scandinavian swordmen. One of the few units I'm worried about here. I do kind of hate that I have to start using you guys in the front lines because I don't have enough men to properly hold a good line here. Let's see, number wise, 128. Charge in there. Oh, I love this cab in this mod so far. Like, I think I'm just getting spoiled with the archer stuff from the Divide and Conquer AGO submod recently. Like, it's so interesting to see the AI, like, properly try and keep track of their archers and whatnot. Instead of just sending them forward and letting them be charged by cav units. Oh, that's beautiful. That's already almost half their army. Archers, do your thing a little bit. My cav kind of just be ready to kind of pull in and start charging them as soon as they engage us. Just kind of run around a little bit. You guys are trying to chase my cav. Just going to ignore you. Ignore you and run around this way to their captain. He's already almost dead. A good charge should finish him off. Oh yeah. I just fucking melt them. Our men have captured the enemy general. Like, I'm not... I know we shouldn't be known for our cavalry, but holy shit is my cavalry broken as hell. I just feel like that's just like what's ramped up in this mod is cav is ridiculous. Kind of just like how in the Divide and Conquer, it seems more like archers are ridiculous. It's like you guys, they're just being shot at. Thank you. Let's finish these guys off here. Because we've almost got the city. I know I'm going to be making money after this.
The enemy force remains.
So kind of keep running them down. We just need to break this one unit. I could just kind of run around. I want you to just be keep being shot at. These guys need some experience. Like, they're doing pretty well so far, even with their kind of mediocre stats for skirmishers. Yeah, only a 2 missile attack, and you're doing that much damage? Wow. Are the armor values just really low in this mod? They might be. Because, like, this unit here... Armor 2? Yeah, okay. You guys have a decent amount of armor 10. These guys have 1, 3, okay. Maybe that's why, it's because the armor's pretty low for a lot of these units. Unless they're a really good unit. As the spear militia units, they're like probably around 3 as well. Okay, if you're gonna keep chasing me... Nope, there they go, now they broke. There's somebody else that hasn't broken just yet, so we've won the battle now. We've now taken out 80, almost 90% of the forces. And there we go. So now, by this point, we've now actually been able to conquer practically all of Sweden, for the most part. There's still Kalmar and some of these southern sections that we need, but I think I'm going to be avoiding them for now. I could take Kalmar, but I'm worried about opening up a border right now with any AI faction, as that could be a very easy way to convince them to attack me. As right now, I don't really have the most troops I can recruit. I really don't. And so I really don't want to try and push into that. Now, though, we finally make money. At least we make money. Let's see. Okay, you guys are at war. I'm not surprised by that. We are slowly growing in power. Slowly, slowly, slowly. Okay. You keep making your way over this way as I'm going to try and talk to the Holy Roman Empire. Try and see what we can do with those guys. You're still trying to explore around here. Try and find as much information as you can. And now we'll try and see. Can we? Let's try and offer to... I'm going to actually specifically try and marry... Marry Princess Heir. I want an alliance. Extremely unprofitable offer. Okay, let's try something small. Try trade rights. That's also unprofitable for you. Let's cancel that.
Until next time.
Because I could try and have you see marry that one specific unit next turn. We can try and do that. Because otherwise, I'm not going to get much out of you guys. So let's see. So you guys, I do have a bit of money. We make about 1,000 per turn. So we need to try and do what we can right now to improve my economy. I don't know why I'm not getting any free upkeep units. Because, like... Why can't you be free upkeep? Are you just not a free upkeep type unit? I feel like that's probably the case. Like, I know... Like, these Viking warriors probably be pretty free upkeep units. I need those Scandinavian swordsmen. But, like, you guys, I think... Let's see, what do I want to get for you? I might grab... Let's see, wait, upgrades armor, protection against enemy spies, and summon plus 10%. Oh, nice. Requires a viceroy with the thinking abstractly trait. Interesting. But no, I think what we'll probably do, let's get those roads built up. Keep trying to build them up. It'll start to compound as I have more and more cities like that. Oh, I could get... Oh. Ooh. How much does that give? Oh yeah, that actually, yeah, just a straight 100 increase. There is the public order due to law decrease, which isn't the best, which kind of sucks. Let's see, because I want to see, like, roads. Central road, cobbled roads, and ground roads. Okay. I see. I like that. Okay, so now, grab these safe trade routes. Try and grab that. That'll be a nice little boost. Otherwise, you can try and build... I don't want you to be for now. Let's get that well. Get that well, and then maybe... It does give a slight increase to tax bonus. Maybe grab that. Public order bonus of 10%, maybe. Due to happiness. Let's get the quarry. Let's get the quarry. Why not? And then you guys up here... There was nothing really to get for you guys. I do need... Give me another priest. We don't have any units to recruit just yet, do we? Now, 4 turns until you're ready. Because this city over here had... I could probably... Are you guys good to lead this guy?
Yes.
You are. Your orders. I'm going on a massive warpath. We're not stopping. We are not stopping until we have as much land as we possibly can. So we'll go for Sala. I don't have enough movement right now, so we'll have to set it up next turn. But I think we'll take this city next. Because then we can try and take Turku. I think we'll... Basically, we've got a good section of Sweden now under my control. It will probably be pretty easy for me to freely take a bit of Finland here, too. So I don't border anybody just yet. And then we can properly build ourselves up after we got a couple settlements around here. Because I should probably be able to easily take Sala. And then maybe Turku before I need more troops? Probably not. I probably need more men before I can take Turku, though. I hate how all of you suck, even though you're technically loyal. Okay, I'm going to hold off on this one just yet. Because I wanted to try and see. Oh, wait, did he leave?
Approach this delicately.
Did he leave? Aw, fuck.
Happily married.
I was going to try and marry that on one dude, but I think he's...
Hello, Your Highness.
He's ineligible now.
Very well.
Ah, damn it. I could try and marry a different general. Could try that if we really want to. Let's see, how long until... Okay, how many more turns do we have on that mission? 3 turns. Okay, because you guys... I can get them this turn. So we can try and talk to you. Let's try and offer some trade rights, as that is beneficial for both of us. And then can I get some map information from you? Unprofitable offer.
9. This is
350 for 8 turns. It's not the worst. I'll accept it. I am making money, so I'm okay with that. Also, does give us a lot more information on what's going on around here. Let's see. What did I get? I got some more bond spearmen. Okay, good. So what I'll probably do is, you make your way over here. I'll pick these guys up and send them over the next turn. So we'll have you guys again kind of do the same thing we've been doing, as this has been working out amazingly well in conquering our lands. I do need another brothel at some point so we can get another spy. Because Visby, you guys... I can't really do anything. I could get the sawmill. The public order bonus wouldn't be bad. It's also only cost 400. I might save my money, though, too. I think I might do that for now. Let's see. Construction not well finished. Got another agent up there. New alliance, Scotland and France. Oh, are they going to fight the English together, maybe? They might. They might not. You guys up here, at least. Let's get this well. Because that does give some public health bonus, so that'll grow the city a little bit faster. As I do need to grow these settlements quickly. I need to get them to the second level. Because I can't get ports yet. I can't get ports until at least the large town, technically. Well, I should be able to get it here. Because ports, where did the ports go? It was related to the large town. It's always a little awkward with this. Because technically, I think it's technically the wooden wall section. Or stone walls. It shouldn't be stone walls for ports. Because as soon as I can get some ports, I think our trade will be a lot higher. As we'll be able to start trading with Visby and everything. Because Visby has absolutely no trade right now. You have no trade. You guys have a little bit here, just from land routes. Most of my money is still in taxes around here, which I'll probably... I could increase that again, but we're making plenty of money. I might want to focus on growth first. Tributes and construction. Am I losing money now? Oh, please tell me I'm not losing money. It should be fixed by the end of us conquering Sala, because I think I'll probably finish up with that. I'm going to... I want to try and marry her off, so I'm going to keep rejecting that for now. Because how old is she? I want to make sure that she doesn't get too old before we marry her off.
Your Majesty?
She's 18. Okay, she's still pretty. She's still. We'll be good. But no, I think what we'll do is let's take Saul. Let's finish taking that. And I think we'll be done for today, as I think this is actually a pretty good start to this campaign. I was a little worried we might be in a hole for far too long with our money, but I've been able to rapidly conquer several settlements. And so that we're not losing money now. We're still a little low on cash. We don't have many more troops. It's very difficult for us to recruit more men right now. Like, if we started a war with the Holy Roman Empire right now, that we'd be dead. If we started a war with Denmark, we might be okay. I know Norway seems to be a hell of a lot stronger than us, so I'll have to be careful about them. I don't know about anything going on in Russia right now, though. And so we'll have to try and get some sort of spy over there and start exploring around there as well. As I should be able to probably be able to take all of Finland and most of Sweden and be pretty safe there before we actually engage and start fighting any of the just normal factions. which I'm really kind of hoping that maybe, like, Kalmar might be safe still. I might be able to go take Kalmar too soon. But you guys, hello there. Oh, you have more archers this time. Oh, if I technically lost this, I'd lose my king. Oh, God. No pressure. No pressure whatsoever. Although we've won several battles like this today, so we're not too worried, but just something could go wrong. What if something went wrong and we just lost my king early on in the fucking campaign? That would suck. Oh, so badly. So let's see you guys here. My general is way over there. Honestly, let's probably move my reinforcements to about here. This is probably the best spot for me to hold up for against the enemy. My god, guys, you're doing it again! Your archers are in front and they're going to die! Honestly, let me just have my archers deal with them. You can deal with them. They're already dying rather nicely. I'm gonna run back here where their general is vulnerable. And he's an archer unit! Oh my god, just go fucking murder him. Like, I don't know what's up with you guys. I think I might have to make sure the next time I fight this, we'll have to see. This is the first time I've played this mod. I went kind of the middle of the road type of general AI. And I'll have to maybe see if throughout this campaign, if it gets better. Or maybe I'll have to choose the harder AI commands, or higher AI difficulty. Because I might have to for this. So far, maybe it's just the fact that I was kept being told that Bulat Steel was hard as shit. So far, I'm doing pretty good into Bulat Steel. So far. I was on very hard difficulty, as I always am. And at the moment, I'm kicking the AI's ass. Absolutely. Fucking lootly. So we'll have to kind of see. Because right now, I think it's just the fact I'm using some pretty bullshit tactics to win. Like, hey, yeah, you're gonna try and fight me. You're gonna walk all the way around your city. So I know, like, their forces are very tired by the time they get over to us here. That they are very prone to routing. To praise the day before and so sunset. It's very but easy for me to break them with the cavalry charges. And we'll have to see if this is gonna keep up when I start fighting some of the actual other factions. Because I can't fully keep up with sieges like this. It's just very useful to use against the AI right now because there's not going to be any forces to go reinforce them and help them. It's just the one city, and so I can very easily just kind of set up in that one little regard, lure them out of the city. It's not going to work as well, I think, with normal factions. But at least right now, I'm going to be the conqueror of Sweden and Finland today. Let's kind of go run this guy down. Because the archers are almost out of ammo. So just keep kind of focusing those guys down. Kind of come back up towards the infantry. I love how this guy's like lost like nothing the entire time I've been using him. Archers have lost a little bit, and you guys are already almost to gold chevrons already. Let's see, they're shaking. I might just finish you off with a charge. Let's see, spear militia! Please die! Yep, can't even brace. Okay, so that's practically all their armies then. Yeah, I'll just run these guys down, and then they'll just keep running guys back over here to try and beat us back. I'm really hoping. One thing I do need to keep in mind, and hope that this is going to be the case, I'm going to hope the AI isn't trying to get me into a false sense of security, where I'm too overconfident, as I am prone to doing occasionally in my campaigns. And then it's going to be like, ah, you thought this was going to be easy? Here, let's have 12 armies invading you at one point or something like that. Never know. The game could just be trying to be like, yeah, okay, just going to log into security, make you enjoy the mod, but want to play the mod more, because you think it's easy, and it's going to be like, okay, this is fine. And then just, as soon as you're just unsuspecting, just bam, right there, you start losing everything. I'm gonna hope it's not gonna be the case. I'm gonna really hope it's not gonna be the case. But I think for now, this is probably a pretty good place to end this video for now. We've conquered a decent chunk of land now. We've now got Visby. We've taken 5 cities today. Oh, 4, sorry. We were up to 5. We've got a good hold on Sweden. I think this is... No, that's actually now controlled by Denmark. That's still rebel. That's now controlled by Norway. So basically, there's only one city left in Scandinavia itself that I could conquer now without going to war with other factions. And then there's a couple stuff over here I can still take, which I'll probably still try and go because that's the rebel. That's the rebel. I could try and set up a little bit over here. Try and take Turku next, probably. But I think we're in a pretty good position for ourselves for this campaign as a whole. But I'm going to end this for now. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this. If you guys did, maybe like, comment, and or subscribe. If you guys did not, please let me know why so I can try and improve. Also, check out my Discord. It's a great way to interact with the rest of my community and get updates on videos. Additionally, there are plenty of other ways. Contains from my channel in the description, so you can check that out. This is Rampaned, and I'll see you guys next time.